you go to your bank account, you don't realize that we have 2.5. That will not actually be right for us. As well, when we have to present management reports. So the rest of the reconciliation is that what you reconcile the balances between the QuickBook balance and your bank balance. Now, in reconciling your bank balances, there are several things you need to consider. The first one is that if you have multiple accounts in the bank, it tends to be very cumbersome. The truth is that if you have, for businesses that have, for instance, when we did deployment for Waka now, we have an account with almost all the banks. So reconciling was a big problem for them until they had to get a software that does that. So what the software does is that it connects their bank account automatically with their QuickBooks accounts and all that. But what we're trying to do currently now is that we're trying to solve that, because there is a partnership we're actually discussing with Remita. You know Remita?
Yeah.
So we're trying to do a partnership with them so that you can easily connect your bank account with your QuickBooks account, like the way we have here. If you are actually using this QuickBook in US, I don't even think your consideration will be an issue, because already all your transactions would have been imported. But because in Nigeria here, that's different. So that's what we're trying to resolve now. Now, in your reconciliation, the first thing to select is the account you want to reconcile. So this will show you your bank account. So assuming I want to reconcile our GTB current account from my own system, if you click that, now this is what the system will show you. Now, you have a GTB account. This is our beginning balance. Enter the following from your statement. This is what we have in the bank at the beginning. Your ending balance is what you have in the bank, not in QuickBooks. So if you have 6 million in QuickBooks and the bank is saying you have 2.5 million, what you enter in this balance is 2.5 million. That's what you enter, not the QuickBooks balance. So the ending date is asset. Let's say the transaction is asset. Let's just use today's date. But you know the constellation is always at the end of the month. So the ending balance you enter here is the balance you have in the bank, not QuickBooks balance. Now, if you move further again, you will see that whether you make withdrawal or you deposit, bank will always charge you for the services rendered. Now, that's where we have our bank charges. So here you come down, you check your bank statement. The assumption here is that it's either you have an e-copy of your bank statement for the month, or you have a physical copy, depending, that's a hard copy, depending on whichever you have. Now, that's where you look at first. Like I said before, you pick the ending balance from your bank statement. You enter the ending balance here. Now, you also check, are there charges? If the bank has charged you 15 naira, 20 naira for COT payment and all that, you add all the figures for that month, then you add it as a bank service charge. So if you add, we will sum everything and giving us 525 naira, 25 cover, you enter it here, or let's use 525 naira. Then the date that charges was deducted, or you could use the end of the month too, because you are summing everything up together. So now this is an expenses. We should go to an account called bank service charge account. But if you look at this, I really do not advise you to map it to just bank service charge. I explained something initially. It's better you map it to a specific bank. So bank service charge, from which bank? You select GT Bank. Then you come down again. For leaving money in your bank, the bank will always pay you an interest, even if it's small. And all that, you also check, will their interest end for that month? If there is, you also add that interest. It's an income. Then you come to interest and 120 naira. Then also an interest income account. Now, the way we split this bank service charge, that's how you create categories for interest income. So you can always add new sub account of the account type will be income and all that. I'm just explaining that so that you understand that you can also split your interest income. Like I said before, the reconciliation is always at the end of the month. So this is just for this training. That's why I'm using today's date. The reason is that if I use end of July, the ending balances are end of July. I may not see anything there. So that's why I selected today's date. Then once you're done, you review. Like I said, before you save any transaction in QuickBooks, always review to be sure that you are correct. Then you click Start Reconciliation. This is where the main reconciliation is going to start from. Now, to start your main reconciliation, it's loading. Now we have this. This is our ending balance, which we have in the bank. This is our cleared balance. Your cleared balance is your QuickBooks balance. Your clear balance is your QuickBook balance. Your ending balance is your bank balance. The difference between your ending balance and cleared balance is what you are looking for, which is the difference. So the difference between what you have in a bank and what you have in QuickBooks is 1.3, which is what we are looking for right now. So now you check your bank, you look at the payment side. Now this is the payment side of this particular account. You can see we have the payment side, we have the deposit side. Now when you look at the payment side again, you check. As you're looking at the payment side of your QuickBooks, you're also looking at the payment side of your bank statement. You want to compare, you want to check if there's any transaction in the bank that is not in QuickBooks, and if there's any in QuickBooks that is not in the bank. Now let's start from QuickBooks first. I have a reason for that. Now you look through this GTB is in the bank with ticks. This Zenith Bank being purchased of dollar, is it reflected in the bank? Yes, you tick. You can see it has changed. Now when you check again, this AC repair technician, is in the bank? Yes, you tick. Now then you come back to deposits section. You are comparing the payment section of your account with the payment section on the bank. Then you come back to deposit again. You check this deposit that we have received from ABC Limited, 900,000, is in the bank too? Yes, you tick. You see that this has reduced. Then you check again, this sales, is it also in the bank? Yes, you tick. Now you come down again, this ABC again that we have deposit of 80,000 naira, is in the bank? Yes, you tick. Now you could see again that the actual difference you're looking for, it's not that 1.3 but 50,000 naira, because we have taken account of all the transactions in the bank and all that. Now if you look at this, you will now see that what you actually have in the bank is less than what QuickBooks is saying you have. Now let's now go to the logical sense. If QuickBooks is saying that we have 2,550,000 naira, and the bank is saying that we have 250, that means we've actually paid someone 50,000. You understand? But maybe the person is here to present that check to the bank. Do you see the logic now? Anytime the QuickBooks balance is more than the bank balance, that means there is likely to going to be a payment that you're here to record into the bank. Or someone might say, I have paid money into your account and it has not reflected, but you have recorded it in QuickBooks. So this is more or less like understanding the logic and all that. So if we look at this now, this may likely be a payment. Oh, we sent 50,595 to a vendor. We just give the person a check. Maybe the person is here to go to the bank. That's why we have already entered it here, and the bank is here to pick that as well. Which means by the time the person go to the bank, that will be cleared. Or in the real sense, no, that's not what it means. What it means is that we have actually given someone a check, but we are yet to record it. That's what it means. Because this is more than this. This is more than this. So maybe the person has actually taken the check to the bank, but we are yet to record that check.
Yeah.
If I go to write check window now to write this check, this balance will be equal to this. So that's where the difference is coming from. So all we need to do now is for us to now go to our expenses to write our check. If I go 50,595. Sorry, expenses. New transaction. So let's assume a supplier. Let's say cyber security is 50,595 GTB. The amount is, I will select out of scope of tax. Because if you don't do that, it's not will tell you that there's no tax selected. 50,595. Then let's say it's for 50,595. Okay. So the payment my Now, it's not just expenses that you make payment for. Assuming you're also buying items, you take this. This for products. So let's say we are buying cyber security antivirus and software. Mm-hmm. What of that amount? So I'll just need to do this. Let me cancel this. 50,595. I think from the right bank, GTB current account. Well, then you save and close. Then if you go back to this, choose inside. See, resume reconciling. Okay. Now, under our payment side, you see that 50,595. By the time you take this, you see difference is zero. So our statement balance is now equal to our bank balance. Then you click finish now. Success, you reconcile your account and click done. All that. So then you now select the next bank to do reconciliation on. So this reconciliation is very straightforward. You understand? The only time you may not have control over the balances in reconciling the balance is when the bank balance is more than your QuickBooks balance. For instance, the bank is saying you have 12 million naira, but you are seeing 11.5 million. And you have already given a supplier a check of 500,000 naira, which is why your balance reduced to 11.5, and the bank is saying you have 12 million naira. All you could do at that point is for you to probably generate a report to say the difference between your bank statement and your QuickBooks balance is the check of this amount. So reconciliation does not mean that you want the balance must always be zero. There are times where the balance is something that you cannot just reconcile. Because reconciling means that you have to go to the supplier to retrieve the check, which is not possible. But what is more important in tracing the differences, saying that, oh, I know where the difference is coming from, is because we gave a check to this person. Or, for instance, again, you actually receive a check from a customer and you have already recorded it here that you have received payment. But then you take it to the bank is yet to clear it. It's still an uncleared check. That's where you still have differences and all that. So those are the scenarios that you have when you could do your reconciliation. So the reconciliation in QuickBooks is also very straightforward. Know that, like I said, the essence is to make sure that the balances you're carrying in your bank is also the same thing as what you have in QuickBooks. So if I go down to my dashboard to check my GTB account, you will see, if I double click here, under go to my chart of accounts trying to show me the balances. From here now, you will see that the current account balance is now 2.5, which is exactly what we have in the bank. So if you want to reconcile this, you do the same thing too and for other banks. Any question on reconciliation? Okay. Alright, after reconciliation, the other part again we are going to discuss is the report section, which is the last part of the QuickBooks and all that. Report section is important, though we've always been coming to the report to see how our transactions have been reflecting in our report. Because one thing about QuickBooks report is that it's real time. You don't have to say, oh, after I've entered all the transactions, I need to start generating reports again, which is one of the major challenges that accountants were facing before now. After you enter your invoice, make payment, by the time you want to generate your statement, you now have to go back to the cabinet again to start sorting all the invoices and all that. But in software, that has been settled. As you enter your transaction, you're already seeing your reports in the real time. Like here now, we can already see how our business is faring based on what you have entered so far. We have income above about 3.6, expenses 29. Then you see your report, which is showing your profit or loss. Then if you now want to drill down, you have more report to check. First is what we call the company snapshot. Now, the company snapshot is an important part of reports. Why? For instance, if you want to see how a business is doing in less than 5 minutes on the real time, let me just see how my business is doing. I don't want to go through any reports. Is there anything that will just summarize my performance for me? That is what company snapshot does. As an instance, you just take a snap of your company as a whole. So that's what it is. I'm trying to open it. Okay, so from the company snapshot, you could see the first one, my income. So my income will show you all the income you have earned. Then it will divide the income. What a portion of that income is coming from where? For instance, you could see that our sales is almost a major part of the income and interest income. Then you also see your expense section. Then you see a breakdown of your expenses. Now, apart from just the breakdown, you can also drill down by dates, by checking this year, last month, last quarter, and all that. Then for the expenses too, you can do the same thing too. You can also drill down. Then the expense section too will also tell you where bulk of your expenses are going to. That is the expense drill down. Then we have what we call previous year income comparison. This is also important. As a business, you don't just say I'm making money. To know whether you are growing or not, you need to compare how much you made this year against what you made last year. So that's where it comes in. So you can also drill down by month or by quarter. All that, then you can see from sales. Then we have previous year expenses too. You also know whether you're able to manage expenses. Are expenses coming down or are they going up? On that, so that's where the previous year expenses comes in. Then you see customers who owe me money and customers I owe. Customers who owe me money will tell you the customers that are owing you right now. Here you will see, these are the people that are owing me. Then who are the people that I'm owing? It will also show you people that are owing you. That's for the company snapshot. Then to move further to the report, you can also check your P&L account. Your P&L account, like I said, is a summary of your profits or loss, how much you've made and how much you have spent. Then if you compare, are we spending more than we're making or less? That will also help us to take decision. Then some other important areas too, apart from the company snapshot and profit or loss, we also have the balance sheet too. Now the areas business are also more interested in is the customer report, which is like a client report to show us the list of all our clients and their balances, how much are they owing us. Even though you are seeing customer who owe me money, there is the report that will also show you who and who are owing you. You can see, so this is the one you can now print out. Like I said, you can also customize this report by going to customize. If you go to customize, then under the header and footer, you can always change the name. From the report title, I can call this list of clients and receivables. Then you run the report. So you can see list of clients and receivables. So then you can also drill down by date to reporting period, either today, this week. Then you can go by custom. By custom will help you select the date you want the report to. And so that's for the customers. Then same thing too, you can also check your reports for vendors or suppliers too, or service providers, by going to your suppliers. You see your suppliers balance summary. Now supplier balance summary and customer balance summary, they are different from customer balance detail and supplier balance detail. The summary will only show you the balance. Okay. Alright, So I said supplier balance summary and the customer balance summary, they are different from supplier balance detail and customer balance detail. Now the summary will only show you the list of either the supplier or the customer and their balance, but the detail will not only show you the list but also show you summary of transactions that's taking place. From the word detail, like for instance, if I check my supplier balance detail, it's supposed to show me my list of supplier and their balance, but because it's detailed, it will show me the summary of the transaction for each supplier. You can see total for AC here too. You can see the summary of transaction bill. So it's not just giving you the balance, but it's also showing you detail of that balances. Then if you also check customers balance detail, the same thing too. You see list of your customers and detail of their transactions. Customer balance detail. You see from here, ABC, we sent an invoice to ABC, then ABC made up, paid us, deposits, the balance and all that. So this will show you detail of each of the balances. So this is very important too. This is also important if management is interested in checking what are the detail of the transaction of a particular customer. Now, if I want to drill down and say, oh, how do I get detail for just one customer? Since the system is showing me for all customers, the where you go to is customer balance summary. Then you go to customer balance summary, then you double click on this figure. Let's say you want to get detail of this customer, just double click on this 3 million here. It will expand it and only show you detail of that. You can see for just this Dangote Limited. And so assuming there are summary of transactions to show you all the transactions, like, and you can always print this out or send it to the customer and all that. So that's the summary of that. Then we have other reports you can check. There are so many of them. When you click here to show you a drop down, you can see these are more reports. Now audit log is another important report. Audit log is like audit trail on desktop version. Audit log help you to check who are entering a transaction. For instance, if there are multiple users on the system, you can see what each users are entering. If there's any modifications, you can also track that. Then we have our balance sheets, we have our B payment, we have our check, we have our class list like we said before, for project monitoring, collection report. Here you will see deposit detail, you see general income by customer, inventory valuation will show you detail of all the inventories you have in stock. For instance, if you have bought softwares at a particular cost, I want to see the list of softwares we have in stock. You will see them under inventory valuation. Then you have list of invoices. Then open invoices will show you all the invoices you have sent to your customer that payment are yet to be made on. That's open invoices. Here you see profit and loss as per of income. So these are the different report type you can check. Now realized gain or loss is basically attached to foreign transactions. Because you've automated multiple currency, there are times where we issue an invoice to a customer at a particular exchange rate, and by the time the customer pay us, exchange rate has increased or reduced. That may lead to what we call exchange rate profit or loss. Now difference in that exchange rate profit could either lead to a loss or profit, like I said before. For instance, if you issued an invoice at 340 naira per dollar and the customer is paying you when exchange rate is now 350, you are making an exchange rate gain of 10 naira. Then if the customer is paying you when exchange rate has reduced to 330, you are making a loss. That is different from unrealized gain or loss. There are two different things entirely. Unrealized gain or loss arises as a result of changes in the bank, your bank balances. You know, we already have a dorm account. If we open our dorm account when $1 is 340 and we pay the $1,000, in naira figure we have 340,000 naira. If dollar increases to 350, by the time you go back to your bank account to withdraw or remove the money you have there, you will see that the value has increased to 350,000 naira. The difference between that 350 and 340 is what we call realized gain. But if dollar has reduced from 340 to like 320, you now have 320. What you have lost is 20 naira. So that's what we call realized loss. So realized loss arises as a result of movement in your bank balances. But exchange rate is for transactions, while realized gain or loss is for bank balances. That's what we have here. So here you will see our reconciliation report. Reconciliation report is basically from what you just did the previous day. From our reconciliation, it will show us how we're able to reconcile our bank balances. Like this is what we just reconciled now. GTB current account. If you click on GTB current account, Yeah, you can see this is detail of what we just reconciled now. Our account balances, all the things that we did and all that. So this is a reconciliation report. You can also print this out. If you have for different banks, you can as well print them out. So that's detail of reconciliation. Any question on this? Now, if there's any reports that you are running often and often more than the other, that's where you see it under frequently run reports. That's these are list of reports that you check more than others. So yeah, if you go to frequently run reports, it will show you the reports you've been opening more than other reports. Any other question on report section? Are there areas that you still think needs to be addressed in as regards your okay. Okay. Well, like I said before, if you have any issues that you think, or because I know there might be one or two transactions that might be free, you can still call in and all that. So what I'll do is I will do a video on it and send to you. You know, if something that can be described on your phone, I will explain. If something you can do a video, you know that. You can see this how management report looks like in QuickBooks.
Okay.
Still loading. You can see automatically generated for you management report marked as security for the period December this and all that. You can see this is to show you the contents, profit or loss, aging and all that, profit or loss figure. You can see here average aging period. Now is showing you the invoices that you have sent and when. You can see these are the key, then you have your sales by customers too and that. So can always print that and send to management. That's on that sales. We have expenses, we have company overview. So that's the balance sheets.